everybody. Tim from Gamiviti here. Today we're going to be doing a little seat repair to this 80 series Land Cruiser. A little white cap, seat gears. You know, something we've been doing for about 10 years now. I've done quite a few of these, but everyone's a little bit different, so let's see what we get into. Looking at the driver's seat, and without even taking the seat out, I can already see the problem. Yeah, that white cap's missing. So that is your first telltale sign. I'll show you that little dude. Needs to be right there. So before we take it out, we're gonna wanna raise this up. Vice grip. Squeezes pretty hard there. Coming with the 12. I want to look at here. One is, look at these gaps here, compare that to this gap. You can see this one's way closer than this, so the whole thing has been shifted to the corner. That's what made this thing fail. So we flip these around. We also want to just check that we have good travel. These things are unrestricted. Take some grease and just stick some of that in here. Take the gear out. You want to loosen this that it separates. Okay, you can pull this up. Side, similar deal. Pull it up, separate it. Here's our gear housing, and there's where the white gear is. Okay. Gear housing apart, it's just two screws. Let's just take a look inside this gearbox so we can see what's going on. If I turn this, I'm spinning that worm gear in there. See, and if I push this out, I can push this worm gear out. So you can see, it's a bunch of old grease we're gonna get rid of. You can see how that turns. So that guy is engaging with this gear, okay? So as this turns, one turns, it turns the other. Here at the vise, about a 16 millimeter, and basically this is going to go in there and be a press tool for us. Bring that over here, line it up, crank it. Side we want to line up. It's going to go just like that. To the vise. Line it up nice and square. Yep. I'm just going to press that guy on. Housing, same kind of deal. Two screws. Most of the time, this one's good. You don't have to replace it, but you can if you're in there. Might as well, right? Just want to walk you down the parts that you took off. So, this is your primary failure point, the motor housing. Right here is where that white cap goes, okay? Motor housing cover with the rubber washer. We have this assembly, goes inside there. These two screws held it on. Guys, they went right here and they held the slide on, so they connected the lead screw to the slide. Got it? These washers were both before and after the motor housing on that knurl piece there. And of course you have this motor housing with this cover right here and those two screws that gear going inside of it. And then these four right here, these are what held the motor housing to the chassis of the seat. And these tiny little guys that held this plastic cover on. So that's it. Pretty simple. Just watch that a few times. Put some grease on that gear. Okay. And we'll take that housing. Put a little bit of grease kind of in that lead screw area. I got it cleaned up. Make that nice and happy in there. Drop that guy in. Rubber washer, put that housing cover right on through the top here. Another deal on the motor housing, grease on there, plop it in. We got our rubber washer never left, so just like that, put our screws in. I've got this motor housing putting the white cap in, right? So you can see this needs to support that little shaft in there. So stick that in there. Set it down. And it really, you just want it flush with the outside of it. You don't need it to be recessed at all, okay? You just want it flush, just like that. One thing I like to do on these housings, make sure that cap doesn't come out. I find a little tiny screw. I'm gonna stick it right in there, just like that. Okay, just gonna hold it. It's not going anywhere. Okay, got one gearbox ready, gearbox repacked, ready to assemble. Before we do, I want to fix these shafts. You notice this guy, we're going to say about 1 1/8 gap from the washer to here. This guy, closer to 2 inches. Okay, so we're going to want to spin that to where he is closer to that 1 1/8. To be the same. Just realize while doing that this guy's missing a part here. See how there's supposed to be this white plastic kind of holder to keep that thing on center? This guy's missing it. So this is gonna be like going crazy. So I don't know what happened to that. I'm gonna try to fix it. Found a fender washer. I don't know if it's gonna work. In there, hopefully hold it on like that. So I just gotta mark some holes and then we're gonna hope for the best, right? Okay, as you can see, can't see it, there's a glare, but these things aren't exactly on center, so I'm gonna try to just move this guy up to there. That it's right across that hole, if that makes sense. Go back to the drill press, we'll see what happens. Okay, over here at the drill press. start with the motor housing here. So this guy's gonna go here. Remember, I had a washer there. This slides through like so. This guy's gonna sneak down into here. Okay. Those guys are gonna go through. Washer. He goes in. So. And then the other washer. Nut. Good. Okay. He's going to go into housing. So. Now the difficult part. Getting this shaft into here. It's where you do a little bit of finesse. You can take that out. Needs to go in like that, and then this, yeah, it's the hardest part of the job, okay? This whole thing needs to bend so that you can cram this down in. Okay, so once you get it like that, it should line up, ultimately slide in place here. Go ahead and do these guys. We got our washers, nuts, washer, nuts. That's good. Okay, if you're like me, you do this all the time. This little guy is down here. You gotta take the whole thing apart to get that back out of there, so just pay attention. About if you ever get a seat where when you stop and go, it kind of like shudders. You feel like there's like that much movement. Sometimes this gets a little worn inside here. What you can do is take this and intentionally twist it. See how it kind of has some play? If you go sideways with it, it's going to be a lot tighter. Does that make sense? Good. Last thing we're going to do is put on that plastic cover. next thing you want to do, tip it back, find that plug. Plug that harness in. Okay, set her back down in place. Cross both fingers. And tighten it to where it's just right there. Finally, there's our little screw that we put in there. And we're just gonna go. So that's it. I hope you found that helpful. Most important thing is just take your time, be happy you're working on your truck and fixing something, and just keep your head straight, and hopefully this goes well. And of course, if you have any questions or comments, love to have them. Until next time, see you guys later.